Hello everyone, my name is Priyanka Shahane. I am working as assistant professor in Artificial Intelligence and Data Science Engineering Department of AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. In this video, we are going to study Bresenham Circle Drawing Algorithm. In Bresenham Circle Drawing Algorithm, radius of the circle and center point of the circle are given to us, and our goal is to generate points of one octant of the circle. The points for other octants are generated using 8 symmetry property of the circle. Now let us see what is 8 symmetry property of the circle. This is circle and it is divided into 8 equal parts. So each part is known as octant. In Bresenham circle drawing algorithm, center point of the circle, that is x0, y0, is given to us. Also radius of the circle, that is r, is given to us. Now let us see steps to solve Bresenham circle drawing problem. Our first step is to assign the starting point coordinates x0, y0 as x0 = 0 and y0 = r. Here r is the radius of circle. Now our next step is to calculate value of initial decision parameter p0, and it is calculated by standard formula 3 minus 2 into r. Here r is the radius which is given to us in our problem statement. Now our next step is to suppose that current point as xk, yk and next point to be plotted by us as xk+1, yk+1, and we find the next point of first octant depending upon the value of decision parameter pk. Based on the value of pk, there are two cases. First case is value of pk is less than 0, and second case is value of pk greater than or equal to 0. When value of pk is less than 0, at that time we use this set of formulas in order to calculate x coordinates of next point to be plotted by us, that is xk+1, y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us, that is yk+1, and next decision parameter, that is pk+1. Formula to calculate xk+1 is xk+1. Here xk is value of x coordinate of current point. Formula to calculate yk+1 is yk. Here yk is value of y coordinate of current point. And formula to calculate value of pk+1 is pk plus 4 into xk+1 + 6. Here xk+1 is already calculated by us, so we just put that value over here and we calculate value of pk+1. Similarly, when value of pk is greater than or equal to 0, at that time we use this set of formulas. Now our next step is to find out value of x plot and y plot, and these values are calculated if given center point, that is x0, y0, is not 0, 0. When center point is not 0, 0, at that time only we have to calculate values of x plot and y plot. And formulas to calculate a value of x plot are xc+x0. Xc is x coordinate of our current point and x0 is x coordinate of center point. And formula to calculate value of y plot is yc+y0. Here yc is y coordinate of current point and y0 is y coordinate of center point. Now our next step is to keep repeating step 3 and step 4 until x plot is equal to y plot. Our step 5 generates all the points for one octant. To find the points for other 7 octants, we follow 8 symmetry property of the circle. Now let us see one problem based on Bresenham circle drawing algorithm. Given the center point coordinates 0, 0 and radius as 8, and we have to find out all the points to form a circle. So we just write center coordinates in and radius of the circle in standard format. Here x0 comma y0 indicates center coordinates of circle and radius, that is r is equal to 5. Radius is equal to 8. Now our next step is to assign the starting point coordinates x0 comma y0 as x0 equal to 0 and y0 equal to r. And value of r is already given to us in our problem statement, so we kept y0 equal to 8 as per our first step in Bresenham circle drawing algorithm. Now our next step is to calculate value of initial decision parameter p0 by this standard formula. Formula to calculate value of p0 is 3 minus 2 into r. So we put value of r is equal to 8, which is given in our problem statement, and then we got value of p0 as minus 13. Based on the value of pk, there are two conditions. First condition is value of pk greater than or equal to 0, and next condition is value of pk less than 0. In our case, value of pk is less than 0, therefore we apply this set of formulas in order to calculate value of x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us, that is xk plus 1. Value of y coordinate of next point to be plotted by us, that is yk plus 1, and value of next decision parameter, that is pk plus 1. Formula to calculate value of x coordinate of next point to be plotted by us is xk plus 1. Here xk is x coordinate of current point. Formula to calculate yk plus 1 is yk. Here yk is y coordinate of current point. And formula to calculate value of pk plus 1 is pk plus 4 into xk plus 1 plus 6. So we just put values obtained in our previous steps in this equation. Now our next step is step 4. This step is not applicable here as the given center point coordinates is already 0, 0. We apply step 4 only if given center point coordinates are not 0, 0. In step 5, we execute step 3 until value of xk plus 1 becomes greater than or equal to value of yk plus 1. And after performing this step, we get our output as given in this table. This algorithm calculates all the points of octant 1 and it terminates. Now points of octant 2 are obtained using mirror effect by swapping x and y coordinates. You can see in this table x and y coordinates are swapped. Here 08 has become 80 in this quadrant. sorry, in this octant. Here 1,8 has become 8,1 in this octant, 2,8 has become 8,2 in this octant, 3,7 has become 7,3 in this octant, 4,6 has become 6,4 in this octant, and 5,5 has become 5,5 in this octant. So here we have like mirror effect. Now the points for rest of the part are generated by following signs of other quadrants. The other points can also be generated by calculating each octant separately. Here all the points have been generated with respect to quadrant 1. These are the references. Thank you for watching.